Hello learners, so today's video is about tables. So we are going to learn about how to create table, how to modify it, how to format it and how to rename it. So starting with this data range which we are having over here, it seems to be like a table but it is not in a table format, it is just a data range. So to convert this data range into table, we are having two options. First is going to home tab, format as table. So there are so many options over here from which you can choose. Like if I choosing this, so this will give me a prompt like that to create table, and the range is selected and I have ticked that my table as headers. So pressing OK will turn this data range into a table. Between data range and table is that there comes a drop down, the filter option in tables. So if these filters are coming, then your data is in a table format. So now doing Control Z, there is another option, selecting the whole data range. Pressing Control T will open that same dialog box for creating table. So here you can do that as like that, and you can change the format. Now you can also name your table, like if I want to name it as marks. So now this table will be referred as marks, and you can give reference to the table name instead of giving the whole table range. Means if you want to give this table range in the VLOOKUP or in some other places, so you can use its name. So you can use its name instead of selecting all this column range from B5 to E12. Going to table design, there are options called header row. It is ticked. Let's say I want a total row column. So this is giving me the total of all these columns. Let's say I want first column to be highlighted. So I've ticked the first column. Then if I want the last column to be highlighted, I will highlight that. Then banded column. So this is giving me certain style in which the certain columns are having format like that. So unticking it will give me like this. Then comes an option, if you don't want the filter button, you can remove it from here, but we want that, so we will keep it here. So next thing is that we are having a table, just we have done some calculations and now we want our table to be converted to range. So clicking somewhere in the table, going to table design and pressing on Control Convert to Range, it will ask you that do you want to convert the table to a normal range. Press yes and it will be converted to a normal range. The formatting will be as it is, but it is converted into a range. This can be identified by the thing that the filter is not appearing on the headers. So I want my data to be in table range because I want some things also. So you can also increase the row and columns of your table by just giving data. So let's say I want some other data to be fed in this table. So let's say I'm typing So see, I have typed a name and it has automatically added the range. And I'm doing here as well. I want the total of the mass. So it has taken. Next thing to note is that you just have to give the formulas in only one range and it will automatically populate it to other cells also. So you can see I have just given the sum formula in the first student's name, but it has populated it in all the students. So in this way you can increase the rows and columns, you can format, you can rename your table for multiple use, you can convert it back to range. So this was all about tables. Hope you like this video. If you found this video helpful, do subscribe to channel. Thank you so much for watching this video.